Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to find the largest and the smallest or the minimum or the maximum value present in a collection or a table in MongoDB. So let's get started. So currently I'm in my command prompt and let me just now create a Mongo shell. So for doing that, just type Mongo, and here you can see, right, so now it has just become a Mongo shell, and here we can run and execute MongoDB queries. So currently I'm having here a database called as TrailDB, and inside that I'm having a collection, and these are the documents that are present inside it. So let me just now display the values or the contents present inside this particular collection. So for doing that, first we need to select this particular database. So for selecting the database, we'll be using use and your database name, try, and just hit enter. So now I'm inside this particular database, and inside this we will be using the trail call collection name. So now I will be displaying the value, okay? And for those who don't know, this is MongoDB Compass. So this just gives us a visual representation of the data that is present inside our MongoDB collections or tables. So it's quite a handy tool, and you can also like manually delete it itself rather than typing it inside the shell. So I would recommend you to download it as also. So now let's just display the data that is present inside this particular table or collection. So for doing that, we'll be using the find keyword. So it's going to be db dot our collection name. We need to specify our collection name. So in my case, my collection name is trail call. So it's going to be trail. You need to be careful with the spelling, okay? So if you make any mistake in the spelling, you won't be getting any output. Trail call dot the find function, and after that just hit enter. So here you can see that I will be getting this exact same value that is being displayed in my MongoDB Compass. So exactly the same name and mark thing. So now let's just move on to our main thing, finding the minimum and maximum value of a particular key. So in this, I'll be trying to find the minimum and maximum value of this mark key. So it has like numbers 100, 10, 50, 70. So I'll be trying to find the minimum and maximum value for this. So the easiest way for finding the minimum and maximum value is by sorting our documents or these particular rows based upon this mark and just displaying the first document. All right, so let's suppose say that at first I am just sorting these values based upon the mark key. So this will work fine for both ascending and descending order. At the time of descending order, what will happen is that our mark with 150 will be displaying in the first, 100 and 50 at the next. So we will be just displaying the first mark when we are sorting in descending order. So 150 will be displayed. So that is going to be the maximum value. And in case if you sort in ascending order, the mark which is lowest will be displayed on the top, and we'll be just printing the first one, which is going to be 15. I know it's quite confusing now, so I will just run a query and explain you step by step. So first thing, as I told you, we will be sorting. So I just have a simple query to sort. Let me just now copy this and let me just now paste it here. So for pasting, right click that. So this is the query that works for sorting in descending order. It is going to be db dot your, wait, let me just now zoom in a bit. Yeah, your collection name, which is trail call, find, sort. This is going to be the key name, all right? In our case, it's going to be mark. And minus one corresponds to the sorting order. If you give minus one, it means descending order, that is largest to smallest. And if you just give only one, it's ascending order, which is smallest to largest. So now let me just show you a demo for descending order sort, how it basically works. And so it's going to be trail call and sort. So you need to be like very careful with this curly bracket and circular bracket, so be careful that. And key name is going to be mark. This means that we are basically sorting our documents based upon this particular key. So if I just now hit enter, so here you can see, right, our documents are ordered on the highest, on the basis of highest value of mark. So I'm getting mark with 150 first, 100 second, 70, 50, 15 and 10. This is basically our descending order. So after this, what we will do is we will just use the limit. So we are having here a limit command, okay? So limit basically displays the top document or a specific range of documents. By top document, I meant is because here I'm giving limit one, because we just need the highest value. We don't need a second one or the third one. We just need the first one. So after sorting, we will just use limit one as a function, and we will be just displaying the first document, which is going to be our largest. Okay, so this is for descending order, and let me show you the exact same thing. And if I just go here and put 1, we will be getting our documents sorted in ascending order, which is smallest to largest. So here you can see, right, exactly the same opposite, 10, 15, 50, 70, 100 and 150. So this time also we will be just using limit of 1, because we just need the smallest one. We don't need the second smallest or the third smallest. So exact same limit 1. So to this sort, we will be adding limit 1. That's it, which will give us only the first one. So I'll just do that. So it's going to be, I'll just go with the maximum 1. So this is the query for max and min. If you want, you can just pause and type it out. This is like a syntax. You need to change the column name and key name. So I'm going here and I'm just going to add dot limit of 1. Yeah. So this query will give us the maximum or the highest value, because we are sorting in descending order. So this will just take this one, limit 1, because of limit 1. If you don't use limit 1, we will be getting like this. So I'll just now come here and, okay, I didn't save it. Okay, mark 1 dot limit of 1, and if I just now hit enter, so here you can see I'm just getting the maximum value, which is mark 150. And if I use this exact same query and remove the minus 1 to just 1, we will be getting the smallest value, because this is getting sorted in ascending order, that is smallest to highest. So we will be getting the first document, because I'm using limit 1. So here you can see I'm getting mark 10. So this is how you find the smallest and the largest value. And final thing that I wanted to tell you is, so what if you wanted to display only this mark key alone? So you don't want this ID, you don't want this name. So in that case, you can just add this particular thing, okay? You can just add this inside your find function. So I'm just going inside find. So you just replace your find with this one. And I'll just copy this one fully. Copying it. Right click. So always I find it difficult to copy and paste. Sometimes it's right click is not working, and sometimes control V doesn't work. So it's like hard to copy paste here. So yeah. So this is basically the query, guys, if you want to only get mark and its value in the output. So this basically has the column name, we need to add the key name, and we need to also like eliminate this thing. So the reason why I'm giving underscore ID 0 is because we will be getting this ID automatically generated by MongoDB, and we don't want that to display, right? And you need to give value 1 for the key that you want to display, and for the key you don't want, you need to just give 0. So this is basically it, and I've just come here, but we don't need to give anything for name, because name is like we are user defined key, but ID is auto generated. So for, we need to specify only for ID as 0, we don't need to give for name. So our collection name is going to be trail call, and here we need to display only the mark. And underscore ID is fine, that's same. And for sorting, yeah, we have to change here also. So we'll be getting the highest mark, yeah. And if I hit enter, I'm getting mark 150 and no other name or other keys. So if you want the name of the person who has got the highest mark, you can just like go here and type name. And if I go and hit enter, I'll be getting name as hello, because hello has the mark 150. You can just try it out for see exact same thing, just remove the sorting as 1. This will also work exactly fine for the minimum value. So I hope you have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done many other tutorials in MySQL query, MongoDB query, C, C++, Java, Python, programming videos in them, as well as thread operations using Node.js and Spring Boot in MongoDB and MySQL. So check those videos, subscribe me, and thanks for watching.